NASA is famous for its exploration and discovery in space. However, the agency is also making discoverers under the Earth, right here on the planet. One of such is the strange new discovery under Antarctica's ice that changes the way scientists have viewed the planet. What has NASA discovered? And does it affect you? Join us as we dive into NASA's strange new discovery under Antarctica's ice. Few people have Antarctica as their dream destination, and that is understandable. Antarctica is the fifth largest continent, covering about 5.4 million square miles or 14 million square kilometers. However, the size varies through the seasons, as expanding sea ice along the coast nearly double the continent's size in the winter. Almost all of Antarctica is covered with ice. In fact, less than 0.5% of the vast wildernesses is ice-free. This place contains 90% of all of the ice on Earth in an area just under 1.5 times the size of the United States. The place is so cold that if you throw boiling water into the air, it will instantly vaporize because most of the particles will turn into steam, while the rest is instantly converted into small pieces of ice. The continent is divided into two regions, known as East and West Antarctica. East Antarctica makes up two-thirds of the continent and is about the size of Australia. Ice in this part of the continent averages 1.2 miles or 2 kilometers thick. West Antarctica is a series of frozen islands stretching toward the southern tip of South America, forming an extension of the Andes Mountains. The two regions are separated by the Transantarctic Mountains, which stretch across the continent and are something times completely covered by ice. Is there planet life in Antarctica? Sort of. It is limited to a smattering of misses, lichen, and algae. Seasonal moss coverage on Antarctica has increased steadily over the last 50 years. However, animal life is much more abundant, despite the absence of amphibians, reptiles, and terrestrial mammals. There are large populations of penguins, whales, fish, and invertebrates thieving along Antarctica's coasts and frigid seas, especially in the summer. What about human life on this wide expanse of ice? While there are no indigenous people in Antarctica, due to the harsh weather, you can find as many as 4,000 visiting scientists spread out across 70 research stations, braving the cold on the continent in the summer. That number drops to 1,000 during the even harsher winter. Antarctica is mainly a hub for climatologists, oceanographers, and marine biologists. However, the frozen desert also attracts astrometry from across the globe. This is because, if you can bear the cold, Antarctica is one of the best places on Earth to observe space. This is thanks to its day climate and the absence of light pollution. Speaking of watching space, this brings NASA, the king of the other universe, into the mix. What has NASA been doing in Antarctica? Looking down from the above, you might think the Antarctic ice sheet looks like a calm, perpetual ice blanket that has covered Antarctica for millions of years. But don't be surprised that the ice sheet can be thousands of meters deep at its thickest and hides hundreds of meltwater lakes where its base meets the continent's bedrock. Now, using the most advanced Earth-observing laser instrument NASA has ever flown in space, scientists have improved their maps of these hidden lake systems under the West Antarctic ice sheet, and have discussed two more of these active subglacial lakes, named Conway and Mercer. The new study provides critical insight for spotting new subglacial lakes from space and assessing how this hidden plumbing system influences the speed at which ice slips into the southern ocean, adding fresh water that may alter its circulation and ecosystem. With NASA's ICE, COOD, and Land Elevation Satellite 2, or ICESat-2, scientists have been able to precisely map the subglacial lakes. The satellite measured the height of the ice surface, which, despite its enormous thickness, rises or falls as lakes fill or empty under the ice sheet. The study, published in Geophysical Research Letters, integrates height data from ICESat-2's predecessor, the original ICESat mission, and the European Space Agency's satellite dedicated to monitoring polar ice thickness, CryESat-2. Hydrology system under the Antarctica ice sheet have been a mystery for decades. That began to change in 2007, when Helen Amanda Fricker, a glaciologist at Scripps Institution of Oceanography at the University of California, San Diego, made a breakthrough that helped update classical understanding of subglacial lakes in Antarctica. Using data from the original ice set in 2007, Fricker found for the first time that under Antarctica's fast-flowing ice streams, an entire network of lakes connects, filing and draining actively over time. Before, these lakes were thought to hold meltwater statically, without filing and draining. The original ICESat mission is credited with discovering the interconnected system of lakes at the ice-bed interface that are moving water around, allowing scientists to study all the impacts on glaciology, microbiology, and oceanography. However, with ICESat 2, scientists had a powerful tool that yielded data so high in precision that they were able to start mapping out the lake boundaries on the surface. Scientists have hypothesized subglacial water exchange in Antarctica results from a combination of factors, including fluctuations in the pressure exerted by the massive weight of the ice above, the friction between the bed of the ice sheet and the rocks beneath, and heat coming up from the earth below that is insulated by the thickness of the ice. That's a stark contrast from the Greenland ice sheet, where lakes at the bed of the ice fill with meltwater that has drained through cracks and holes on the surface. How deep below the surface are the Conway and Mercer lakes? These hidden game of frigid water are hidden beneath 1.2 to 2.5 miles or 2 to 4 kilometers of ice on the southernmost continent.